There is only one reaction anyone has ever had to witnessing a big, modern, micro LED display in person. It goes something along the lines of, whoa. They are quite simply stunning to behold. It's no surprise then that when popular TV brands started teasing us with micro LED TV prototypes 7 years ago, folks started dreaming about the day that they might be able to have one in their own home. But here we are, 7 years later, and I'm willing to bet that none of you watching this video have a micro LED TV. I mean, maybe I have some ultra wealthy fans out there who recently ponied up $110,000 for an 89-inch Samsung micro LED, but I'd say the odds of that being the case are kind of slim. I don't know, maybe somebody is gonna surprise me in the comments. Point is, it's been 7 years of hoping and waiting and still no commercialized consumer level micro LED TVs. I mean like 55 to 85 inch models below say $25,000 or so. But is 2025 our year? Let's talk about that. Welcome back everyone, I'm Caleb Dennison, and I'm not sure exactly when and where I saw my first micro LED display. It might've been Sony's booth at Cedia or CES when they showed off their crystal LED integrated structure, or Cletus for short. I don't know why that makes me laugh. Hey Cletus, get a load of this here TV. It may have been Samsung's first the wall display at CES. I definitely remember that 146 inch monster. Shooting that video was an absolute blast for me, though it was a nightmare for my videographer at the time. Anyway, I, like everyone else who saw it, was gobsmacked when in 2018, these amazing displays with perfect black levels, insanely intense brightness, and next level color were first shown off. Then in 2019, Samsung showed a 75-inch micro LED display, and I really thought at the time that micro LED TVs might be just right around the corner. Alas, it was not to be. In 2020, again, more micro LED hopes from Samsung. Samsung has been working really hard on this stuff, and to be fair, so has LG. LG just doesn't seem to be making as big a deal about it at trade shows, I feel. In 2021, well, nothing much happened then because CES didn't really happen, not really. But in 2022, 2023, and 2024, more micro LED displays, some small enough to be considered a TV replacement for a decent number of folks, albeit mostly folks with very deep pockets. But where's the micro LED TV that competes with today's top OLEDs? One in a 65-inch, 75-inch, or 85-inch size? What is taking so long? And is 2025 our year? We'll see micro LED at CES again, I guarantee you. But will we see it in TVs at Best Buy? Can we buy one and mount it on our wall? Well, I'm gonna go ahead and put my neck out on the line here and deliver what some of you may find disappointing news. Contrary to popular belief, I do not have superhuman soothsaying powers. But with that said, no. I don't think we're getting a normal sized micro LED TV anytime soon. In fact, I'm starting to doubt that micro LED, as we've seen it so far, will ever be a viable at-home consumer TV technology at scale. Even with Hisense recently showing I think it was a 163 inch micro LED display at IFA earlier this year, and likely at CES 2025. But why? What's so dang hard about making micro LED TVs? And if not micro LED, then what is the next big thing in displays? Into what tech should we put our hopes and dreams? I'm gonna try and explain everything in easy to understand terms, and my hope is that by the time you finish watching this video, your expectations will be fairly managed and we can all avoid further disappointment next year. First, a quick primer on what micro LED is for those of you who aren't sure. The way LEDs work in today's LED, mini LED, or QLED TVs is as a backlight. See, these are actually all LCD TVs. The LCD layer is where the pixels are, and they use color filters, sometimes also quantum dots, which I'll explain shortly. They use that stuff to make the picture that you see. The LEDs, or mini LEDs, are basically flashlights in the back of the display that make the light. They don't make the color or the picture. They are not themselves pixels. But a micro LED display is different because the minuscule light emitting diodes, micro LEDs, are the pixels. Micro LED displays actually have more in common with OLED TVs in this way. You apply voltage to these micro LEDs, which are broken down into red, green, and blue subpixels that combined can make any color you want. There's no color filter, no LCD layer, just tiny lights combined to make a picture. And they can get way, way brighter than the compounds used in today's OLED TVs. So you get the best of all worlds, perfect black levels, infinite contrast, and extreme brightness, along with the hugest color volume possible. That's why micro LED looks so amazing when we see it. So then, what is so hard about making a micro LED display? Well, there are several challenges, but the primary challenge is pixel pitch. Pixel pitch refers to the distance between the center of each pixel. For context, the pixel pitch on the 4K version of Samsung's 146-inch The Wall micro LED display is 0.84 millimeters. That's 0.84 millimeters between the center of each pixel to get 4K resolution that doesn't appear to be pixelated or blocky from normal viewing distances in typical homes. On the 89-inch 4K version of Samsung's micro LED display, the pixel pitch is about 0.8 millimeters, a little tighter. But if we drop down to a 75-inch micro LED display, the pixel pitch would need to be about 0.43 millimeters. That's about half of what we see in Samsung's 146-inch The Wall. And that, my friends, is the massive challenge. The robots that are tasked with placing the micro LEDs on a substrate have to be insanely precise. Those are some massively expensive robots. And apparently, as precise as they are, it's a marvel, really. The yield of acceptable micro LED displays with that kind of super tiny pixel pitch is relatively low. Because if there are any errors, if anything is out of alignment, even just a tiny bit at that tiny scale, it will be pretty easily visible to us. Larger micro LED displays are much more forgiving, relatively speaking. We tend to view those from further away, and that's why we see them used successfully as huge display signs, or in Sony's case, as very realistic looking backgrounds for film sets. Now, there are some new exciting pixel printing technologies coming on the scene, but so far, those are for very small displays, like the sort that you would see in your glasses or on your watch. Now, not only is the pixel pitch thing a huge challenge to pull off from the printing perspective, but micro LEDs generate a lot of heat. And the tighter you have to cluster these micro LED pixels, the more heat management has to be implemented. And that has also been very challenging. Perhaps that's why most of the micro LED prototype displays that we've seen so far have been modular. I don't know if it's slightly less challenging to make a smaller module, but I do know that it's way easier and way less expensive to toss out a bad small module than it is to make a big old thing and then have to toss out that entire display. What they're doing there is minimizing the cost of their defects. And you can also make heat management a little less challenging when you're doing it at a smaller modular level. In short, micro LED display making is extremely difficult, extremely expensive, and low yield. I probably don't have to connect the dots for you to understand that this is just bad business. If you can only make a few of something, and that something is going to be massively expensive, you aren't gonna sell very many of them, and you're probably gonna lose money, or at best, break even. Not good business. Caleb, you say, I heard Apple was gonna make micro LED displays for Apple Watches. Certainly, if they can do it that small, they can do it at something like 55 to 85 inches on a TV, right? Yeah, I heard that too. They tried, and then they canceled those plans because why? It was too expensive and didn't add sufficient value. Now, I'm not suggesting that a true RGB micro LED TV will never be a thing in your living room, but I feel fairly confident that it won't be happening anytime soon. If I end up getting proved wrong about that, hallelujah, I'm okay getting proved wrong. I just rather keep my expectations low so I'm not disappointed, and if it does come to fruition soon, I'm gonna be elated. But there may be hope for micro LED in the near future yet. It might be possible to ease this pixel pitch problem a little, and therefore lower costs and increase yields with the technology that's become almost ubiquitous in TVs over the past 11 years. Quantum dots, often referred to as the Q in QLED or the QD in QD OLED, are tiny nanoparticles that glow a certain color when you shine light of a certain wavelength on them. I've got a whole video about how quantum dots work in TVs if you feel like checking that out. But it could be possible to ditch the red, green, and blue micro LED subpixels and instead take a QD OLED-like approach to micro LED by using one specific color of micro LED and getting the rest of the colors from quantum dots. In fact, I feel pretty confident that when micro LED does land in our living rooms, this is how it's gonna work. How close are we? Honestly, I don't know. I think we're probably several years out. But again, I'd love to be proved wrong. Anyway, I think a QD micro LED is probably the best way to go. But if not micro LED, like at all, then what? What could be the next level display tech that revolutionizes TVs? Well, again, I think it's gonna be quantum dots to the rescue. Except in this scenario, the quantum dots won't simply glow when light is shown on them. They'll make their own light, just like micro LEDs and OLEDs do. Yep, I'm talking about electroluminescent quantum dots, which in inner TV nerd circles, we've been calling QDEL. Sharp Display Corp is actively working on QDEL technology. I showed it to the world on this channel during CES 2024. It was very much in its early stages then, but I happen to know that Sharp has made some progress. I just don't know how much progress has been made, and I don't know if Sharp is gonna show it to me again at CES 2025. I have asked though, and I'm hopeful. But according to what Sharp told me before, making a QDEL panel is not that challenging. In fact, existing production methods can be used, and it doesn't have to be done in a vacuum, like literally in a vacuum environment. The cost of production won't be all that high. Lower than OLED, according to what I've been told. So in that way, QDEL sounds extremely viable. The trick, I think, is gonna be ramping up the brightness. As I understand it, the challenge is making a more efficient or brighter blue electroluminescent quantum dot. The red and green quantum dots are pretty well dialed, but the blue needs to catch up in order for a QDEL display to get sufficiently bright. And I understand some progress has been made, I just don't know to what degree. But yeah, QDEL is the display tech that I am most excited to learn more about at CES this year. Fingers crossed. But Caleb, what about PHOLED? Yes, PHOLED, P-H-O-L-E-D or phosphorescent OLED technology. What is it and how does it fit into this discussion? Phosphorescent OLEDs are more efficient than standard OLEDs. You can get more brightness with less electricity. But again, it's that blue color that's been holding things back. Blue PHOLEDs are less efficient than red and green PHOLED compounds, and so they've been holding back PHOLED displays from getting to that next level brightness that we want. But PHOLED does hold the promise of reducing burn-in risk, and it reduces energy consumption, both factors that make pursuing PHOLED very desirable. For me though, PHOLED is more evolution than revolution, so I'm still more excited by the idea of a QDEL TV or a quantum dot micro LED TV. In the end, we're gonna have to wait and see what happens at CES 2025, but I have my doubts that micro LED is the undisputed king of future TV tech, at least on the short term. I would not expect inexpensive, normal-sized micro LED TVs to appear on store shelves in 2025. I think we'll see what looks like promising progress at CES, but in 2025, I think most of the TVs that'll end up on store shelves are gonna be the same mini LED, LCD TVs, and OLED TVs that we had in 2024. Except, I think they're gonna be a lot more expensive in 2025 than they were in 2024. But that, my friends, is gonna have to wait for one of my very next videos. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. If you wanna know why TVs might be way more expensive in 2025 and why you should absolutely buy a 2024 TV sooner than later, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss my next videos. And as a bonus, you'll be all set to see all the latest at CES first, right here. Click that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video and want me to make more like it. Drop a comment with your thoughts down below. I can't wait to chat with you all about this. I'll see you on the next one. And until then, here's two other videos I think you might like. But could 2015 be the year that we finally get micro LED TV?